So we are reading from Bhagavad Gita as it is, along with commentaries of Srila Baldev Vidyabhushan Pad, chapter number 3, Karma Yoga, text number 21. So we have discussed in the previous shloka, are there any examples of a person who has gained perfection by doing Nishkam Karma along with Bhakti? The example was Astitaha Janakadeha. That Janakadi, that means kings like Janaka and others, were situated in self-realization by following this prescribed path. So now, the question can be raised that why a person who has realized his self has to do his prescribed duties? He does not have to. But to set an example for others who have to prescribe duties, there is no harm in doing it. His doing prescribed duty or not doing the prescribed duty does not impede his self-realization. Agar kuch karta hai, kar raha hai, toh bhi koi dikkat nahi hai, nahi kar raha hai, toh bhi koi dikkat nahi. But when he does his prescribed duties, because he's a leader, that will help others who need to do prescribed duties because they will see it as an example. Now the Lord here in this shloka will tell this as a principle. And this shloka was also quoted in Chaitanya Charitamrita, why Mahaprabhu came, or Krishna came as Mahaprabhu, so that he can teach the principles of bhakti by his own example. So we'll discuss this. We'll try to discuss as much as possible. Although the commentary of Prabhupada gave very small commentary, but the shloka is very, very profound. Oh, I'm sorry, it is not 21. It should be 20, na? Got mixed up. Where is that? Yadya Dacharati Srishtas. So, oh, he named wrongly. Oh, oh, this Rahul Prabhu. Oh. This is stupidity. Now it's okay. So we'll not discuss 3.22. We'll leave him. He's not there. I was confused. I said 21 is not being shown there. Okay, okay. Now it is okay. Bhagavad Gita text number 21. Yad yad acharati shrestha tat tad eva taro janaha sayat pramanam kurute lokastad anuvartate yad yad acharati shrestha tat tat eva taro janaha. Priyam is not speaking. Why are you not speaking? Can you not speak? Krishna has given you tongue. Please chant the shloka after me. Do you think I am not seeing you people? Okay. Yad yad acharati shrestha tat tad eva taro janaha sayat pramanam kurute lokastad anuvartate yad yad acharati shrestha tat tadeva taro janaha sayat pramanam kurute lokastad anuvartate. Everybody should learn this shloka. Very good. Learn it and apply it. Please chant. We chant more than normal. Yes, chant. Yad yada charati shrestas tattadeva taro janaha tattadeva taro janaha sayat pramanam kurute lokastad anuvartate. Anish Prabhu. Yad yada charati shrestas tattadeva taro janaha sayat pramanam kurute lokastad anuvartate yad yad acharati shrestas tattadeva taro janaha sayat pramanam kurute lokastad anuvartate. I am not seeing the lips of the Zoom devotees moving at all. Are aise awaaz honi chahiye. Brahmanas should chant like this. Maharaj always makes fun. Is always Radha Govind Maharaj. Yes, yes. These Matajis, when they will have to do prajalpa, they will speak so loudly. Or otherwise, actually otherwise also, other people. But when they have to chant shlokas, अरे भाई डो बट नो बडी ही इज हियरिंग योर रॉन्ग प्रोनाउंसिएशन टू एटलीस्ट साउंड लाउडली वॉट यू वरी चैंट बोलो बोलो नहीं नहीं हो रहा ओके ये चैंट यदि यद आचरति श्रेष्ठास् तत्तदेव तरो जनः सयत् प्रमाणं कुरुते लोकस्तत् अनुवर्तते। ये सब लोग याद करा के मानूंगा, इससे पूछूंगा बाहर खड़ा होकर गेट पे किसको याद हुआ तब जाने दूंगा ब्रेकफास्ट के लिए। यस
यदि आचरति
श्रेष्ठास् तत्तदेव तरो जनः सयत् प्रमाणं कुरुते लोकस्तन अनुवर्तते। यस नाउ आफ्टर हियरिंग इट यू कैन चैंट। यस चैंट 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 यद यद आचरति श्रेष्ठास् तत्तदेव तरो जनः सयत् प्रमाणं कुरुते लोकस्तद अनुवर्तते। एनीबडी एल्स? यस चेप्पंडी। यद यद आचरति श्रेष्ठास् तत्तदेव तरो जनः सयत् प्रमाणं कुरुते लोकस्तद अनुवर्तते। यस यद यद आचरति श्रेष्ठास् तद्दद एव तरो जनः सयत् प्रमाणं कुरुते लोकस्तद अनुवर्तते। सी बाय हियरिंग दिस श्लोकस अगेन एंड अगेन देन यू लर्न। इट्स नॉट दैट यू हैव टू लर्न नेसेसरी संस्कृत। We have learned all the languages was our mother language by hearing our mother, and our mother did not teach us grammar, did she? Do you know the grammar of Telugu? Little bit. So your mother first taught you grammar. Simply by hearing we learn, is it not? Malayalam and all those complicated languages, just hearing, is it not? So it's very simple. The shloka directly you can understand. Yad yad acharati shrishthas. Yad, yad, what, whatever, whatever. So in that way, acharati, shrishtas, a person who's superior, he shows by example, tat, tat, that, eva, certainly, itara. Itara means apart from that, apart from the shrishta. The person who's not the leader, all those people who are not the leaders will be called itara. Itara means separate or alag, different. So, janaha, janaha means his followers. So, whatever example a leader or a teacher will set, his example will be followed by the followers. This is a siddhant by Krishna himself. So if we want to preach, what we should do? Teach by example, and it is very easy. I will try to say so many quotations on this. Sa yat pramanam kurute, whatever he establishes as praman or an established fact or a evidence, yes sahi hai, this is correct. Kurute lokastad anuvartate. The people in general follow that. Anuvartan means to follow, become a follower of that. Does it make sense? It's very, so many examples will come in this regard. So I'll try to explain. But let us go first into the translation. I think it's very easy to understand the shloka. Difficult to apply it. Translation. Whatever action a great man performs, common men follow. And whatever standards he sets by exemplary acts, all the world pursues. It's very easy to understand. Gita Bhushan commentary. This verse shows the method of instructing the population. That was discussed in the previous shloka, how Arjuna as a leader, as a warrior, as a kshatriya, he must perform his duties so that the common populace will be instructed or benefited from this. Whatever action the greatest person performs, the others, itaraha means others who are not great, even the low persons will follow. Whatever scripture the superior person considers in performing his actions, the lower person will follow that. Beautiful commentary. We'll discuss each of them. First, let me read it. Thus, the meaning here is that the best actions authorized by scripture should be performed by the inferior persons who desire auspiciousness. At the same time, whimsical actions performed by the superior or powerful person are rejected because though they are performed by the superior, they are not approved by scripture. Let us first understand the commentary. Beautiful commentary. First of all, people are, as they say that monkey see, monkey do. You understand this? One monkey will see another monkey, maybe elder monkey, superior, senior monkey, but he will do as his monkey, as other monkeys do. This is very, very profound. If you enter an assembly where devotees are chanting japa very sincerely, you will become like that. Even unknowingly, you will become like that. If the parents are devotees, they have a devotional atmosphere in the family, automatically the kids at least become pious, if not devotees, at least. All of you I'm meeting are from a pious background kind of, like normal pious background because the family was pious. Wo samajh rahe hain? If a family is meat eating, then you naturally become a meat eater. Does it make sense? It's just natural. Because we see our mother doing like that, we see our father doing like that, so we do like that. You remember Mrigari? When Naraji asked him, why are you slitting the throat of the animals? Why don't you kill them completely? He said, that's how I've seen my father. So, in this regard, is a very nice quotation. I'm just talking about whatever other person does, we do like that, especially the great person. Your actions speak so loud, I can't hear your words. Have you heard this? Can you understand this? Your actions speak so loud, I can't hear your words. If I tell all of you, you must eat only half the stomach of your hunger. And you see, Shukrish Das Ji is making a big giriraj and swaha, swaha, anyor, anyor. If I tell you, you eat 9 a.m. and 5 p.m. and I say every hour Prabhuji has a plate of prasadam coming in front of him, how will you listen to me? So that's why in my preaching, I try to preach what I can follow myself. I cannot eat half stomach and survive. Maybe good as per Ayurveda, I cannot do that. So I say, then you become weak and eat one single time. I don't prescribe. I cannot do that. But if I cannot do, then how can I expect others to do that? So samajhna chahiye na? I can't sleep just 4 hours and practice Krishna consciousness with the proper sane mind. I just cannot do that. So preach or teach what you preach and preach what you teach. Does it make sense? Teach what you can follow and follow what you teach. That is much better. Easy to understand. I can't chant 64 rounds every day. How can I preach about it? I can tell for myself. I can do some 16 rounds and some extra rounds and do some service. It makes sense to you? Yes. If you don't do it yourself, what will you say? And people will one day see that you are not doing what you are preaching. This is for sure. And then their faith completely breaks. Samajh rahe meri baat? But the positive thing is, on Zoom you can teach and you can preach also and preach by your example. I'm repeating it because this is a very important point. You see, why our Zoom thing is becoming so popular? Some of the devotees, popular means for me 120 devotees is a big thing, you know. Because they are seeing a whole group of devotees who are with the same attitude, with same intention, same focus, chanting Hare Krishna. It is very rare to find that way. You see, devotees who come to see our Goshala Ashram, you won't hardly find anyone who is doing prajalpa or wasting his time, except me. But you won't find that, is it not? That's why some of the devotees are afraid to come to our ashram, because they think I am too strict. Which I am, in a sense. But those who want to practice bhakti, they want to be in the ashram because they know I am strict. Because I am. Kuch samajh rahe meri baat? I asked our Venum Vadan, Venji Vadan, are you happy? He's very happy. He's more strict than me. He works about 1:30. So anybody who wants to do hearing and chanting, he becomes happy. Our Prabhu is so happy, Gaur Gopal Prabhu. I think Amarnath Prabhu also is happy. Maybe. Is it not? Samajh rahe na meri baat? So if I tell you, hey Marnath, why did you not come for Mangal Arati? And you see, Prabhuji is coming at 5 a.m. Prabhuji, You may not say this. You may, out of fear, you won't say this. But you will definitely in your mind say, Baba, ye kya bol raha hai? You should sit in temple and chant, or at least sit and chant. And I am just roaming around and walking, talking. People, many leaders, I don't want to say this, but I'm seeing even, I don't want to say that, but many leaders, when they are preaching, they just don't understand that you have to set an example. I was coming back after my initiation, and the devotee, we had met some devotees, and the devotee leader there gave a wonderful class in the evening, in the train. And next day, he was sleeping like this. I mean, little bit I can understand, but if you sleep like this, then what class I can hear from you? Why I'm saying this? Don't be like this. Unless you stop sleeping in japa, don't preach. Because if they see, obviously it's not a Brahma Vakya, you can still preach. But if you want to sleep, you switch off your video and then sleep. Don't sleep in front of your students. It gives a very bad impression. I am not myself enthusiastic about chanting. What I can tell to others? I am not saying that I have taste for chanting. At least be enthusiastic about chanting, is it not? I know these are my personal views, but that's what I understand. I have seen how my Guru Maharaj is chanting. How I have seen my counselor, His Holiness Bhaktir Samit Maharaj is chanting. I have seen how His Holiness Loknath Maharaj is chanting. So, I want to follow in their footsteps. Does it make sense? And I want to follow every one of you to follow like that. Not that you speak so many things in the pravachan, but chanting Hare Krishna phus. I know this class is a little heavy, but if you chant Hare Krishna very nicely, you will be enthused to preach. Does it make sense? And I'm telling you, this is a fact. So many devotees give me this feedback. Oh, we come on Zoom and that Mataji chants so nicely. They never told me that you chant nicely. They never tell me. Because I maybe don't chant nicely, but this, that Mataji chanting very nicely, that Prabhu is chanting very nicely. So you see, even new devotees, so to say junior devotees, are setting a good example, setting a mood for others who are coming to join. And this whole group of devotees are chanting very nicely. I'm only talking about Zoom and only talking about chanting. Are japi nahi kar payenge, theek se kya acharan karenge, bataiye aage. Hai ki nahi? If I can't chant my rounds properly, what acharan I can do for anything else? If it appears this class is very heavy, it is supposed to be heavy. Samajh rahe meri baat? Because this I have seen so many times, that people speak so many things, but when it comes to practice, they don't want to practice. Even simple things they don't practice. Simple things. So we should not be like this, and it becomes very easy. You will see, you say something and you keep on practicing like this. Well, practicing your whatever you are doing, you will be benefited, and people, it becomes very easy for people to learn. I give an example. I just saw His Holiness Radharaman Maharaj, and he just doesn't talk nonsense. I don't have much association with Maharaj, but I just learned one thing. He just doesn't talk nonsense. Never ever. That is very profound, you know, simply by seeing a Vaishnav behaving in the proper Vaishnav etiquette. I've seen him, obviously, there is no question of fighting. Never enter into politics or anything for that matter. Aap samajh rahe meri baat? So you want to be like that Vaishnav. Kuch samajh rahe? So we have to be very good examples so that other devotees who come forward in the future generations, they can see that example. Okay, we are not Paramhansas, but we can at least do something good about it. So I was just talking about any great person. See, everybody is a leader in some regard for some people, is it not? Even like Richa Mataji and Juhi Mataji are teaching to the kids. So they they look up to the teachers, is it not? So when you chant, obviously they don't sleep, I'm just saying. And anybody of you whom you are preaching, they will look up to you as a teacher, is it not? Like Rudra Prabhu is teaching to your mother, is it not? Mother and sister. So if they see you chanting, they will be inspired. Oh, my son is telling me and he's chanting nicely. Does it make sense? Don't think, Prabhuji, hum to keval seva ki rahenge. I won't be leader for anyone. It's not like that. Make sense? So when we do like that, people will learn very easily. Okay? Now, we go forward in the commentary. Even the low person will follow. This is so beautiful line. He will not know scripture. It's not that everybody will understand scripture and everything. But just seeing that devotee or seeing the superior, he will imitate. And that is very good. Kuch samajh rahe hain? Just seeing that devotees, they will imitate, and that is very good. I have seen how very rarely I've seen, but Maharaj, my Guru Maharaj came, I think maybe 4 or 5 times in 12 years, 13 years. Very rarely comes. But he will sit down, his hands in a very intense way, like Siddhasana, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. So I see even some of my God brothers who won't normally sit down and chant, they will be around Maharaj and chant at least nicely in front of Maharaj. At least that much is there, you know, I've seen how Holiness Loknath Maharaj comes. He chants very intensely. He used to before Corona time. So all his disciples will come and sit down, at least chant with him nicely. Baki time to masti karenge alag baat hai. Matlab ye nahi keh raha sabhi masti kare. They may do masti, matlab they may just not do that much seriously. I am not saying all the disciples of Maharaj are like that. I'm just saying some disciples may be like that. But when they see the spiritual master in front of them, then they actually chant nicely. Now see, that's why Maharaj program is so successful. Now everybody can see the Maharaj chanting Hare Krishna. So, and Maharaj can also see them. Then they at least in front of Maharaj, they with a video on Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, they will chant very nicely. They may not be very enthusiastic on their own, but seeing the leader, they will behave like this. Makes sense to you? And in that, anyways, we will be benefited. It is not. If he set a good example, I was telling about this. Are kam se kam dikhava to karo. At least make a good pretense of doing bhakti. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. Maybe your mind is going all the places, but at least show that you are a very nice chanter. That's very good, is it not? And then you'll become a good chanter. I am focusing mostly on chanting. Same thing with Shastra. And most important, serving in a selfless spirit. That is extremely important. If I see my teacher, spiritual teacher I'm talking about, he is working for money, he's selling his katha for money, all those things. What will I become? I will become like that. I will tell you the truth. This is one devotee. He just came to our ashram for some time. He planned to become a professional Bhagavat reciter. Actually, he had a plan. It's acha mota paisa hai. This is a lot of money in this. But then when he came in the association of devotees here, he gave up the idea. I said, never do that. Become a sweeper, but don't become a professional Bhagavat reciter. So you see how he's seeing that, how the local pandit or brahmanas, they're getting a lot of money simply by doing these things. So let me also do like this. Samajh rahe na meri baat? But we see Srila Prabhupada and his followers preaching selflessly. So we also become inspired to serve Krishna in that way. Samajh rahe na meri baat? Whatever scripture, beautiful point, whatever scripture the superior person considers in performing his action, the lower persons will follow that. What scripture Srila Prabhupada followed in his life? Bhagavad Gita, Srimad Bhagavatam. What will we follow? Bhagavad Gita, Srimad Bhagavatam. If somebody says, that scripture says this, that scripture says this, na. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu Matamidam Tatradara Napara. Mahaprabhu's mat or opinion is Srimad Bhagavatam is the highest pramana. Now we don't pay attention to any other pramana. Are you able to understand? Because Mahaprabhu says Bhagavatam is the highest pramana. Make sense? Some people will tell you, chant in the mind, chant this. Mahaprabhu is chanting aloud all night. Case closed. Somebody will say, chant Hare Krishna, don't hear Hari Katha. Mahaprabhu is doing Hari Katha, is it not? Case closed. We don't want to hear so many opinions, this is good, that is good. We see how Mahaprabhu is doing bhakti. We can directly see from Chaitanya Charitamrita, is it not? Okay, should we distribute prasadam? Yes, Mahaprabhu himself was distributing prasadam. Even, what is his name? Sarup Damodar, who is an intimate associate of Mahaprabhu, he is distributing prasadam to Vaishnavas. Did you not hear yesterday how he is bringing prasadam for his Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya in his own, what is that, Anchale? Anchal? Anchal means cloth, his own sannyas cloth. So should we just remain aloof and just sit in one place and meditate? No, Mahaprabhu is not doing that. Obviously, he chants Hare Krishna mantra alone also, but he is lovingly, having very loving reciprocation with Vaishnavas. Ko samajh pa rahe meri baat? So simply by studying the behavior or character of Mahaprabhu, we know how should a devotee should behave, how should he live his life. Are you able to appreciate? And same way, when Lord Krishna was there, he behaved like a perfect Kshatriya, like a perfect householder, so that people who are supposed to be householders or need to be householders, they know how Krishna should behave. We have discussed, how a householder should behave. We have discussed that in chapter number 61. Discuss means we have given reference, you can read that. And how Krishna is embraced by his wives. He's so beautiful. Their wives love him so much. But he wakes up for the Brahma Muhurt hours. So householders have no scope for saying this, oh, that person is a grihastha, I am grihastha ashram, how can I wake up for Mangal Arati? That doesn't fly. You see, Krishna himself is doing that. Lord Ram himself is doing that. So how, why you cannot do that? Make sense? So, yes. So, for we can see for ourselves also, what scripture we consider best? Bhagavad Gita, Srimad Bhagavatam, Chaitan Charitam. So that's what the previous acharyas have accepted. So we will accept like that. Now, one more thing, that the behavior of a great person has to be as per scripture. This point also has been brought about in this commentary. Kuch samajh rahe? The great person should also behave like scripture. It's not that we assume that he is great and we are following him. We can't assume that. Kuch samajh rahe? People follow so many philosophers. I don't want to name them, but their behavior is not as per scripture. One philosopher very boldly says, what is the value of Tulsi Devi? You should grow begun plants. Begun. You can eat the begun. But they don't understand Tulsi Devi eats all your sins. You may eat the begun, but you won't get any piety. But Tulsi Devi simply by looking destroys. She eats all your sins, is it not? She eats up all your karma, she eats all your sins. And she takes you back to God. She eats you also. She takes you back to Godhead. So that fellow can't understand because he does not have a scriptural knowledge. Why? Because his teacher also was not like that. Again, Prabhupada gives the example. His teacher, I think you must be understanding whom I'm talking about. He is in Anand. Now, but he does not have any Vivek. Now you understood what happened. So now his teacher says, oh, my student, I have given you everything what I have. Now I'm a beggar. And Prabhupada tells in his purport, this is not a spiritual life. That the teacher will give all the knowledge to the student. And then he says, I'm a beggar. I don't have anything. It's like I'm saying, I give you all the knowledge of Bhagavad Gita. And now I don't have any knowledge of Bhagavad Gita. it doesn't happen even in material life, is it not? How will it happen in spiritual life? Rather, we have heard in Chaitanya Charitamrita, the more you distribute love, 100 times it increases in your own account. So you see, people may follow such philosophers, but this is all bogus. B-O-G-U-S, nothing else. This has no Shastric basis. That's what the Acharya is explaining here, that the best action authorized by scripture should be performed by the inferior person who desires auspiciousness. What is the best action authorized by scriptures? Chanting Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Ram Ram Hare. Very clear. We are most inferior people, but if we want any auspiciousness in our life, we must have some chanting at least in our life. And I think you must be feeling that how by completing your rounds nicely in the morning, you feel so peaceful. And we don't know what is going to happen at 9, 10 a.m. Is it not, Shiva? Yesterday what happened is that we were taking very nice khichdi. Khichdi is so nice. And then suddenly somebody was fighting. Was it not? Aapne kal dekhe the na? You should always have this attitude. Anything can happen at 9 a.m. So before all this happens, the whole world starts, you complete your chanting. Because things are not in the control after 9 a.m. I mean, normally. Make sense? And beautiful point, whimsical actions performed by the superior or powerful person are rejected because though they are performed by the superior, they are not approved by scriptures. Now, what is the evidence? You see, when Lord Vamandev came and he demanded something from Bali Maharaj. So, Bali Maharaj says, no, I have chanted Om and Lord Vishnu is asking, why should I not give him? And then Shukracharya, who was a superior, said, no, don't give him. So you see now in that situation, Bali Maharaj rejected the instruction of Shukracharya. Does it make sense? So if the superior says, don't chant Hare Krishna, don't pay obeisance to Krishna, or don't surrender to Krishna, don't accept that superior, even if that person may be your father or mother or brother or whatever. Or whatever, any teacher or anything. Pita na sasyat, janani na sasyat. You know that shloka from, can you find it out? I want to. Fifth canto, fifth chapter. It's the thing around 14 or 15 afterwards, or something like that. Person does not have a license to give birth to children. You put it like that. If you cannot deliver them from bondage. So most of the people are, most of the kids are unlicensed products from unlicensed factories, if I want to put it like this. Because what to talk of teaching the kid? If the kid is being taught bhakti, they say, why do you do bhakti? Kya bhakti ka ke liye kar rahe? Very nice shloka. Gurur na sasyat, swajano na sasyat, pita na sasyat, janani na sasyat, devam na tatsyan, na patishcha sasyan, namo chayed yat samupeta mrityum. 5.5.18, Lord Rishabhdev's teachings. So Lord gave, Rishabhdev is giving the license. Yes, yes, you can be guru. But you cannot, let me just put it the way Lord is putting. Guru na sasyat, you cannot be a guru, you cannot be a relative, you cannot be pita. You cannot, pita means father, you cannot be janani or mother, you cannot be a demigod or husband or swami, unless you can deliver the person who is under you from the clutches of death. Now somebody says, very difficult Prabhuji, but it's not difficult. If we give the same knowledge what we have received in disciplic succession, it's very easy to deliver a person. Very easy, not, I've repeated so many times, chant Hare Krishna and don't blaspheme others. Mahaprabhu will himself deliver you. Case closed, simple. Kuch samajh rahe na meri baat? So now you should hear this very carefully. If, I'm repeating it again and again, if somebody says don't chant Hare Krishna, don't do bhakti, you may externally respect them, but just don't hear them. And if you're not economically dependent on them, just don't stay with them, even if they are parents or whatever. You are all economically dependent, is it not? Don't go to home, okay? Don't go home. Kya kar lenge aap? 18 saal se to bade gaye na. You are beyond 18, is it not? You are working. You are not brahmachari, so we are not captured you. And even if you have captured, you are beyond 18. You can stay wherever you want to stay. Hai ki nahi? You are not a minor. Don't be that much, how is that, weak. Because I am repeating this point, if we lose this life, they will not, they cannot, just cannot help us. They can only cry. Beyond that, they just cannot help us. I don't see, these things are just ingrained in my heart. They keep on coming again and again in my lectures. We don't have to hate them, but understand that they are not able to give us guidance. Okay? So if they are behaving in a way which is not approved by scriptures, we must not accept them. Okay? Purport. People in general always require a leader who can teach the public by practical behavior. Have you ever thought why corruption never stops in India? Have you ever thought? Because the leader is rascal. So if the leader is honest, then the person who subsequently will think, oh, I should become actually good one. Like, it's just a fact. Like Sanak Sanatan Prabhu is honest. I never joined here to gain money. So we are both honest. I mean, I'm not verifying, but that's we don't have money in our mind. We have only service in our mind. So people under us can cheat us, but not under our, how to say, shelter. We don't allow them to cheat. They may cheat with all their, little bit they can cheat, but they can't cheat whole scale. Just like I give an example in Gomata products, it was all happening in front of me. Somebody gave us bad ghee. And I said, no, we are not going to sell this ghee. This is very bad. I tested it. Very bad. You're not good. So that fellow told to Natwar Prabhu, do you want some commission? And Natwar Prabhu is also honest. So he says, see what this fellow is asking. So I said, take this all this thing back. You will be surprised. One time at another point of time, I also was in charge of devotee kitchen. And I gave lift to somebody, some fellow. And he says, who's kitchen in charge? I don't know why. Suddenly he just started asking. He said, I am the kitchen in charge. I sell potatoes. I will give you 10%. Even though I was in saffron, I said, what? So you understand? That's the whole point. You know, so if the leader, if I was cheater, then all the people who are under me, they will become cheaters. And this cheating can also happen in terms of preaching. Yesterday, Akash Prabhu asked me this question, is it not? Why the person who wants to merge in Brahma Jyoti is the person who wants to merge in the body of Krishna is more worse than a person who wants to merge in Brahma Jyoti. What was the answer I gave? I don't know. I have not discussed. I just looked up at the purport and gave him the exact answer. this cheating mentality is prevalent everywhere, not only in terms of money, in terms of how I behave, what scriptures I quote, and everywhere, is it not? And I'm again repeating, if you want to become a preacher, if you don't know, say, I don't know. I'll look up our senior Vaishnavas and I'll talk and give you a reference. But if they find out I spoke from my concoction, then the faith is immediately lost. I can make mistakes. That's like I was talking about Lord Ram and I was speaking Krishna. Is it not? That happened. That can happen. That we can accept. It's a mistake. It's called Pramad. By mistake, it can happen. But if you intently say wrong, people lose faith. Don't you remember? I said, I'm not glorifying myself. I'm just saying what example I'm setting before you, all of you. I did not know whether Sankarshan expanded into Narayan. Is it not? I said, I don't know. What is the difficulty in saying this? No difficulty. But when I heard from Srila Prabhupada, now I can give you evidence. Srila Prabhupada in this lecture says Sankarshan expands into Narayan. Kya dikkat hai, batai? So don't try to present ourselves as a very learned scholar. Just repeat what the previous acharyas have said. Make sense to you? Then people have faith. Ah, Prabhuji is saying correct. Makes sense? This is very easy, very easy. Okay. A leader cannot teach the public to stop smoking if he himself smokes. Very easy, is it not? Don't smoke. Don't smoke. Like this. It doesn't work. I know that how in IIT, the teachers were so degraded. Not all of them, but few of the professors, they will smoke just outside the door. Even the smoke will come inside the class and they will come and teach the class. It's so abominable. What character you learn by becoming a PhD? It surely explains PhD means permanent head damage. They don't know anything. Lord Chaitanya said that a teacher should behave properly before he begins teaching. One who teaches in that way is called Acharya or the ideal teacher. Therefore, a teacher must follow the principles of Shastra scripture to teach the common man. Are you seeing how Srila Prabhupada is deriving from the commentary directly? The teacher should learn the scripture, first of all this, and he should behave as per scripture. Samajh rahe na meri baat? And the common man who does not know scriptures will follow the teacher. So in that way a person will be delivered. The teacher cannot manufacture rules against the principles of revealed scriptures. Hear very, very carefully. You see, Guru, Sadhu, Shastra, you know this? This is our meter of checking how whatever something is correct or not. So Sadhu is speaking, my spiritual master Guru is speaking, but both should speak from Shastra. I think all the devotees who are hearing Chaitanya Charitamrita classes, they must have noticed whatever Srila Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami speaks, He corroborates it or he gives a proof from Bhagavatam, yes, from Shastra. How beautifully he speaks, is it not? That's the way we should learn to speak. Never say, Shubh Krishna Prabhu told, he told, that told. Don't quote like this. You can quote if I am saying something from Shastra. But if you quote me and somebody says, from where does the Shastra speak, then it's very complicated. Obviously, I don't speak apart from Shastra. But even if you don't just take names. Obviously, when I quote from Maharaj. So Maharaj tells from Shastra. You may not know which commentary is speaking, but he speaks from the commentaries of the Acharyas only. Makes sense to you?
Yes.
And certain things is an observation which you can directly perceive also. That is a different thing. But main point in kuch clear nahi aa raha, if something is not clear, then the evidence is Shastra. Why you should understand? Suppose we three of you are Asatari. Yash Prabhu is there, Amarnath Prabhu is there, I am there. And all three of us have three spiritual masters. Fine? No problem. Now you quote your spiritual master, you may quote your spiritual master, and you have faith in your spiritual master, and I quote my spiritual master. Fine? That also fine. But for me, your spiritual master is Sadhu, and for him, he may be a common man. He may not have that faith. For me, your spiritual master is Sadhu. For him, he is a common man. And for my spiritual master, you may perceive my spiritual master as a common man and he may see him as a Sadhu. So the common point of faith is Shastra. And a proper Sadhu and Guru will never speak anything except from Shastra. Clear? And that's how we should train ourselves. We don't know, we keep quiet. So I'll look up in Shastra, I'll look up as consultation from senior devotees and then let you know. Is it okay? Don't think that people are foolish. Always remember, don't think that people are foolish. They will find out if you speak nonsense. Then they won't listen our lectures. I mean, we are not interested in listening or not listening, but we have failed to provide proper truth. There is a possibility that we can't understand something properly and we can make a mistake. That can always happen. Because the more you refine your consciousness is, the more you can understand the truth. That may always happen. That always happens with everybody. You become more refined, you understand it more in a refined way, then you can explain it more. But your intention should not be to cheat. And if you do make a mistake, you accept, I made a mistake there, we change. Just like I made a mistake regarding Dattatreya. I said, oh, there's one avatar. No, there was all three avatars in one, but it was not like that. I just corrected later on. That's what I'm saying, that's what I do, and you should all be like that. You make a mistake, you accept it. Okay? But golmaal nahi karna, golmaal samajhte na? Anyhow, they don't know. Let me just cover up everything. Yes. The teacher of you discussed this. The revealed scriptures like Manu Samhita and similar others are considered the standard books to be followed by human society. Thus, the leader's teaching should be based on the principles of such standard shastras. One who desires to improve himself must follow the standard rules as they are practiced by the great teachers. The Srimad Bhagavatam also affirms that one should follow in the footsteps of great devotees and that is the way of progress on the path of self-realization. What is that shloka? Mahajana. Mahajana is yena gata sapanta. That is from Mahabharata. What does Srimad Bhagavatam say? It's just hitting, not coming into my consciousness. A very beautiful shloka, I think, is from Prahlad Maharaj's statements. Nishkinchinanam na vranita yava. This is one thing he said. No, this is by Rahuguna too. This is by Jad Bharat to Rahuguna Maharaj. So it is very, very important. I'm just forgetting that shloka. Anyways. That is it. Balir Vyasaki Vayam. The 12 Mahajanas. This is told by Yamraj. Forgetting. He said that this path of Bhagavad Dharma is initiated or practiced by the great devotees, the 12 Mahajanas. I'm just forgetting how it starts. In 6th canto, 3rd chapter. Balirvayasaki vayam. Shastra also disappears. If you don't practice the shloka, just disappear from your mind. Prahlada Janaka. Swayambhu Narada Shambhu. Swayambhu Narada Shambhu. Prahlada Kapilo Manu. Yes. Swayambhur Narada Shambhu Kumara Kapilo Manuhu Prahlada Janako Bhishmo Balirvayasaki Vayam Dvadashate Vijanimo Dharmam Bhagavatam Bhattaha Guhyam Vishuddham Durubodham Yam Gyatvam Ritamashnute. Beautiful shloka. 6.3.20-21. Swayambhu means Brahmaji. Swayambhu doesn't mean Brahmaji. Narada, clear. Shambhu, Shivji. You can put the earphone. Kumaraha, 4 Kumaras. Kapila means Lord Kapila, son of Mother Devahuti, not the atheistic Kapila. Manu, that Prabhupada mentioned, Manuji. Manu means can refers to all the Manus. Prahlad, very easy. Janaka means father of Mother Sita. Yes. And Bhishma, Bali Maharaj. And Vyasaki means Shukadeva Goswami. And Vayam means refers to Yamraj. Yamraj is we. So all of us, these 12 people know the Bhagavad Dvadash Ete Vijanimo Dharmam Bhagavatam Bhata. Bhata means, oh my dear servants, this very confidential Bhagavad Dharma is known to these 12 peoples. Simply by chanting Krishna, unknowingly also, a person destroys billions of lifetimes of sin. It's not an ordinary thing. It's not explained in normal Dharma Shastras. Guhyam, that's why it is very confidential. Vishuddham, it is pure, it is not contaminated by modes of material nature. Durbodham, and even if it is explained, it is very difficult to understand. Yam, gyatva amritam ashnute, a person who knows this dharma, he will become liberated from bondage. That is the potency of Bhagavad Dharma. Samajh rahe na meri baat? So now a person who follows them, he will also understand. So these, if somebody says, are difficult hai, if it is so difficult, then nobody will understand. No. A person who follows these 12 Mahajans, he will also understand. So this is the path. This is one shloka coming into my mind. Other shlokas also are there in Bhagavatam. The king or the executive head of a state, the father and the school teacher are all considered to be natural leaders of the innocent people in general. All such natural leaders have a great responsibility to their dependents. We have quoted this shloka 5.5.12. Therefore, they must be conversant with standard books of moral and spiritual codes. Extremely important for us devotees, because now the leaders are rascal number one. Andha yathandir upaniyamana tepi sutantra urudam nibadda. Leaders are blind and the followers are blind. And leaders don't declare that we are blind. If I am blind, if my leader is blind and he tells me, Prabhu, I am also blind, I am searching for my leader. At least I won't take his shelter. But he says, no, I will show you the right path. I'll somehow then make you happy. Is it not happening? Can you see this happening? I don't know if you have that audacity to ask your parents. But ask them, have you become happy by all your endeavors, what you have done in your life? Shiva, why don't you try that today? He earns money and so fearful. Have you ever been happy? I remember my father had colitis, diabetes, ulcer, and so many things. And I asked him, are you happy? Yeah, I'm happy. I said, what happiness? You have so many diseases. Now what you can answer beyond that? So it's a very beautiful point Srila Prabhupada sent here. I don't know whether you noticed this. Beautiful point. Word, only word. Natural leaders of the innocent people in general. Beautiful point. Amazing. You see, this example has been given by the Vishnu Dutas in second chapter. If suppose there is an animal who has taken shelter of a person, having faith that this person will protect me, can that person slit the throat of that animal? Another example, fifth canto, same Rishabhdev 6 teachings. If a person is blind and is on the verge of falling in the ditch, will a person who is intelligent will kick him by foot? Maharaj was speaking that a person speaks a katha by his legs and hands also. But I'm just doing this. Will you kick him? Is it proper? And please don't mind, but our parents who are not devotees, if they are not devotees, they are doing just the same with us. Money, work for money like a dog and die like a dog. Is it not? We have no problem if you earn money or something. But they don't encourage you to do bhakti, is it not? Most of the parents. Very, very. Just like a small child. What a small child knows. But it's very, very, very emotional statement actually. A chota bacha kya janta? Kuch bhi nahi janta na. Abodh rehta hai na. Completely helpless. Similarly, even if a person is aged, he's completely helpless. He does not know what a dangerous life he's leading in human form of life. If he does not offer his activities to Krishna, he's going to become an animal. It's a very heavy statement what Prabhupada is saying. Innocent people. And on top of it, they make all the arrangements so that people become bewildered from the real goal of life. Do you agree? Make all the arrangements for movies, make all the arrangements for liquors and all those things. Very dangerous thing in Kali Yuga. So it's the duty of the devotees at least to preach this message to as many people as possible so they get some light in their life. Simply by chanting Hare Krishna, a person can go back to Godhead. But does everybody chant Hare Krishna? No, because they don't know about it. Okay, I'll stop here, but you got the point. So we must try to chant Hare Krishna very nicely, practice bhakti nicely so that we get our realizations, and then with conviction we can tell to others, no, this really works. I have a very simple example. I had a skin problem. Our Ramavatar Prabhu, who's a very nice doctor, Dr. Baum, he gave me medicine which cured me very nicely. So one devotee told me today, I could not come, Prabhuji, because that had skin problem. And I've seen how itching can make you really give a lot of trouble, whole day, whole night you're itching and you can't sleep properly. So I said, okay, you just talk to the doctor. You understand why I'm giving this example. I have taken the prescription, got myself cured. So I'm telling to others also, simple, is it not? I'm not a doctor. So if you chant Hare Krishna, you see how your heart gets purified. How we can see ourselves as an eternal being, actually. How we can see our identification of the material world stopping. Actually, so then why will you not preach to others? What will remain for you to live except to preach? You will see how everything in this world is useless एज वी कीप ऑन चैंटिंग हरे कृष्णा, कुछ नहीं कुछ सध नहीं रहा है हमारा, वी आर नॉट गेनिंग एनीथिंग इन दिस वर्ल्ड, एवरीथिंग इज टेकन अवे बाय डेथ एंड डेथ कैन कम एट एनी पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम, यू कैन इस कैन एक्चुअली सी दिस, देन यू विल प्रीच ऑल्सो, एंड इफ यू हैव यू आर कन्विंस्ड विद दिस यू कैन सी इट, योर प्रीचिंग विल बी डिफरेंट, इट्स नॉट लाइक पैरट पैरट लाइक स्पीकिंग, दैट्स व्हाई साधना इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. ओके, गुरु न सस्यात, ओके, या वी हैव 5518, नॉट 5512, आई एम सॉरी. One who cannot deliver, yeah, we have discussed this. Does consciousness immediately degrades even if we have the tendency to cheat? It is a symptom of degraded consciousness. So we should learn to be honest. Why? Please hear very carefully. This is very dangerous. If I say, you can eat grains on Ekadashi, no problem. If I tell, so he will get the sin of eating the flesh of cow and I will also get the sin of eating the flesh of cow. Because I inspired him. This is Siddhant from Bhagavatam. A person does something, a person who inspires him, and a person who gives him facility, they get the same result after death. Be very careful. So that's why if somebody asks you regarding dharma, be very careful in giving prescription. Otherwise, just keep quiet, as I don't know about it. Certain things are very easy, like somebody asked me, can we offer chai to Laddu Gopal? Very easily you can say no. People ask all sorts of questions, you know. But is it equivalent to Vaishnava Aparad? I don't know. Vaishnava Aparad is different. Vaishnava Aparad means blasphemy of Vaishnavas. Cheating is different. This is equivalent to Vaishnava Aparad, Prabhuji, since we immediately lose faith if we cheat or do any such things. I don't know in what context you're saying, but what I understand is, see, if I tell something, just like I quoted 5.5.12, that was a mistake. It's just now Prabhu told 5.5.18. That can always happen in lectures, you know. A slip of tongue can always happen. Everybody, it happens with everybody. Wo ho jata hai. But intentionally, if I say, no, 5.5.12 only. No, no, it is, I was correct. 5 point, Bhagavatam is wrong. 5.5.12. That is wrong. I must say, it's very easy to accept your mistake and say sorry. What is the difficulty? More difficult to cover your mistakes. Do you agree? Main aisa nahi bol raha tha. Main ye kehna chahta tha. I want to say like this and blah, 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 blah. Why? Just what this for me, it is very difficult, I must tell you, to have a relationship with any person who just speaks lies. Are you make any kind of mistake? What is the difficulty in accepting it? I remember a very nice incident with you. It is really funny. I was feeling very much disturbed in my mind. It is like 10 years back or maybe whatever. So Sanak sir, and I was, you know where I stay in Goshala. So from Prabhuji's window, he can see who's there, not there. So he gave a call to me. I did not pick up. My mind was not in a good condition on that day. Very long back. So then he gave the ring to another brahmachari who was staying with me, Pran Govind Prabhu. He said, very Shubh Krishna. So I told Pran Govind Prabhu, tell to Sanak Sanatan Prabhu, he's not there in the ashram. That's what they say, is it not? I think this is the last lie I told him. This is the last lie. And I told him, and then Prabhuji said, I can see him in the ashram. Tell him to call me. I said, he's a German inspector. I should never ask lie. So we fight also. We argue also because we are a little bit intelligent. That is all going, but we never tell lies. Yes. So why should we tell lies? Make a mistake, you accept. Was it not? Prabhuji, I'm sorry. Let us go forward. Yes, yes, okay. In Vaishnava relationship, you should never, obviously in your practical dealings, you might have to tell lie, but actually our tongue becomes contaminated, becomes impure by speaking wrong words. Just like on that day, I'll repeat the same thing. I told on that day that earlier my mind was impure. When thoughts of women will come, I enjoy. My mind was enjoying. Now it was saying, kya kar rahe, right? So now that person says, Prabhuji, why are you telling like this? What people will think of you? I said, let them think whatever they want to think. If they don't want to hear my lecture, no problem. But I cannot tell you that untruth. I'm not a Paramahansa. I'm just telling you I had this kind of problem. And by chanting Hare Krishna, I'm getting purified. It's not me. It's not my mind. I am not my mind. I'm telling the situation. I had a problem with my mind and my mind is getting purified. And this is a problem with 100% sadhakas. Everybody is like that. Just to encourage them, I'm saying. As somehow it's happening with me, I cannot speak lies. I just don't like to speak lies. It's a good thing, you know, some brahmanical qualities coming. And also I can't hold secrets. Don't tell me any secret. I just can't hold anything. If you say to Prabhuji, don't tell to anyone, I will tell to everyone. So you don't tell me, I'm not a Kshatriya. I can't hold secrets. Maybe I will not take your name, but I will tell in the class. I just can't say if it instructs somebody. Okay, so just like I told, somebody has worshipped the Lord for hundreds of lifetimes with mantras. He gets qualified to chant Hare Krishna. I directly read in the commentary. I think I shared also.
Yes, sir.
No, I shared in the Holy Grail group also, something somewhere I have it. So now today one person asked, Prabhuji, very inspiring. Can you give the reference? No problem. I'll give him, when the class finishes, I can very easily give the reference. If something I would have spoken on my own, I give you one more powerful thing. If I focus my mind on Krishna here, that will benefit the whole world. Do you accept it? What was Dhruva Maharaj doing? Now, you do have the evidence? Dhruva Maharaj was just fixing his mind on Krishna and the effect was on the whole world or not. Now do you accept? Now do you accept it? See? ऐसे नहीं दिख रहा ना आपको कि एक व्यक्ति भगवान कृष्ण के बारे में स्मरण कर रहा है, हाउ द होल वर्ल्ड विल गेट्स बेनिफिट, बट जगत पवित्रम प्रगणित करहिचित, द होल वर्ल्ड गेट्स प्यूरिफाइड इफ डिवोटीज टॉक अबाउट कृष्णा. भागवतम फर्स्ट कैंटो, आई थिंक व्हेन नारद स्पीक्स, फोर्थ चैप्टर समवेयर, मेक सेंस टू यू? सो दैट्स हाउ वी शुड स्पीक. दिस इज वेरी अमेजिंग, इज नॉट? वी एवरी डे कम टूगेदर टू चैंट जप, ट्राई टू फोकस ऑन माइंड ऑन कृष्णा, एंड दैट देयर इज बेनिफिटिंग द होल वर्ल्ड. इट्स एक्चुअली अ फैक्ट. You can't perceive it immediately, but that's a fact. So I'm just trying to say, whenever we speak, we should speak from Shastra. That way we also become convinced, and it is convincing to others also. Devotees do yajna, and in turn, Mother Earth provides grace and thus benefit all. Yeah, that's a fact. Okay, so I hope you understood the point. And also it gives us a very important point. Why should we keep our video on when we are in Zoom? You see, as soon as you switch off your video, you can do anything, is it not, when you chant japa? I mean, I'm talking about those who actually come on Zoom. What do you think, Vipin? You can also watch a movie and chant Hare Krishna. You remember one day, you've seen that quite funny thing happened. One devotee was watching his smartphone, and the reflection of the smartphone was falling on his glasses. And I immediately chastised, "Hey Prabhu, what are you doing?" So you see, if it have kept the video off, then he could have done whatever he wanted to do. So that's up to us. But it creates a very good impression when we come together. I'm talking especially from the context of Zoom, or in otherwise also when we behave properly. Just like that devotee yesterday behaved so badly. If all the devotees in Saffron behave like this, will anyone like to become a Saffron Brahmachari? Never. Never ever. One devotee behaved very badly. I felt very, ashamed that I am from the same batch, you know. Same batch means same category, same saffron. Last point I would like to say. I'm not promising it is the last point, but hopefully it is the last point. Indra was kidnapping the horse which was the sacrifice horse of Prithu Maharaj. And you know how he was coming? He was coming dressing like a sannyasi. So 3-4 times he came. And then when his Prithu Maharaj's son was rushing after Indra, he would assume himself as sannyasi, then he will not kill him. So I don't know who they instructed. Is it Brahmaji? Or I'm not forgetting who instructed, but he said, Prithu Maharaj, he said, you stop this sacrifice. Why I should stop the sacrifice? First of all, you are incarnation of Supreme Lord. You don't need to do all these sacrifices. And Indra, by behaving like a false sannyasi, is creating a very wrong example for Kali Yuga. In Kali Yuga, seeing the example of Indra, there will be sannyasis who will be the dress of sannyasis, but won't be sannyasis. They only cheat. So it's very important that devotees perform Krishna consciousness nicely. I stopped wearing glasses. What does it mean? I don't know. Maybe something from Vedanta Sutra. I don't know. What I cannot understand Akash Prabhu's comments. He's too subtle. Okay. So, shall I stop? You have any other? Yes, Prabhu. One more point. As a devotee, you should never misbehave with your parents. Never ever. Never ever. But don't listen to them. Make sense? Yes, Prahlad Maharaj was not listening to Hiranyakashipu, but paying full obeisances. Rather, they should feel shocked. What? Ye ladka to kabhi paav hi chuta tha, pranam karna. That is fine. You serve them nicely, you be very good to them, but never listen to their advice. You want to say something?
As you read that, you should also remain humble. How do you maintain that practice?
Because as a leader, we should remain humble. So how we should remain? At least try to be humble. If you can't be humble, at least be respectful. Is it not? Humble means you don't expect respect. Even if you expect respect, at least be respectful. Humble means you expect some respect also. That's a fact. And that is very dangerous, because then people can give you really trouble. If you start expecting from people that they should listen to you and all this, you have given the key of your happiness to them. It's very difficult for people to listen to anyone except their mind. So if you start expecting people to do exactly what you're telling, just can you do exactly what anyone else tells you? Very difficult. So how you can expect others to do like that? So be patient on that. But it's a very key. We should not think that everybody will do exactly the way we want them to do. Hota nahi aisa kuch. Everybody thinks he's very intelligent and he knows much better than you. You know that? You also think like this. Everybody thinks like this. Everybody, I'm a bahut buddhiman. So slowly they will understand. See, every time I'm hammering is complete your rounds before breakfast. But some people think, no, I am more intelligent. I'll eat nicely and chant nicely. Yes, they may be, but you know what happens after eating, is it not? I just can't process a video also. It just takes few seconds after eating. No, whole consciousness is changed. So if people are more intelligent, what you can do? So, okay. Okay, so we shall stop here. We can do pranayama and then we'll stop here.